Hello, Midwest corn growers. Today we're going to be doing a quick video on seedling blight. It'll be the first in a series called Disease 101 that we're going to do on several common corn diseases that occur in the Midwest. So when we talk about seedling blight, there's several different pathogens that cause seedling blight. We also have to have the right environmental conditions, mainly cool, wet soil. And then we'll also talk about timing and when the infection and damage occurs. So whenever you talk about disease, I sure like to talk about the disease triangle. And first off, you have to have a host. So if we're talking about corn, we're gonna plant corn, we're gonna have the seedling that's gonna be the host. So usually the timing of infection is around germination through the V3 timeframe. We talk about the pathogen. There's actually many different pathogens and strains of the pathogens that's common in about every cornfield in the Midwest. We have Fusarium, Diplodia, Rhizoctonia, and Pythium. With Pythium, it's been found that there's like 14 different strains of Pythium, 8 different strains of Fusarium, so there's a lot of different pathogens out there to deal with. Then, like we talked earlier, we also need the right environment. So that's usually cool, wet soil, extended period of just completely saturated ground in your poorly drained areas of your fields. So when we talk about seedling blight, we'll talk about ways to identify it here. The main thing is to look for missing plants. As you see, there's a lot of missing plants in this picture, or look for stunted, wilted plants that are getting ready to die. When you find those, get a shovel and dig them up. And the first thing you want to look for is this mesocotyl, the stem between the seed and your crown, and look for that to be rotted or shriveled up. And also you want to look at your roots. A lot of times you can see rotted roots. There's another picture here of zoomed in mesocotyl that's rotted. You can see some pathogen and some damage there on the corn seedling as well. So now that we've talked about how to identify, how can we prevent and manage this seedling blight disease? One thing is to get a multiple mode of action seed treatment, such as Acceleron. That will help prevent a lot of your seedling blight. And other than seed treatment, one of the big things is don't plant deeper than needed. 1¾ to 2 inches deep, for the old timers, 2 knuckles is perfect for planting your corn. You want to make sure you're planting into some moisture. 3 inches is really the max. If you're planting into dry soil and you can't get into moisture at 3 inches, I would wait for a rain. Also, your problem fields. So you probably know fields that you've had issues with in the past, or fields that have a lot of wet spots or wet holes in them. That might be the fields that you want to move to the end of your planting order, where it might be a little warmer. Maybe wait till you're closer to 55 degree soil temperature to plant. That will help those corn seedlings jump out of the ground faster, less time for the infection to occur. Also, you want to do everything you can to prevent compaction and improve drainage. I know not everybody can afford pattern tile, but maybe do a little tillage in your wet spots when it's dry and try and loosen that soil up so it'll drain and prevent the pathogen from taking over with the right environment. Then another thing you want to do is scout after emergence. So when we get about 110 to 120 heat units, you want to be out walking your cornfield looking for those plants coming out of the ground. If you have a heavy crust, might be a good idea to try and get out a rotary hoe if there's no rain in the forecast. Could also do a very light irrigation if that's something that you're capable of doing to help the corn pop up out of the ground. And thanks for joining. That kind of wraps up our seedling blight video for today. Please stay tuned for more Disease 101 videos coming this summer.